In PiVision 2020, you can configure different time contexts for your trends on a display. I'm Jeff Resnick with OSI Soft Learning. Let's take a look at how we can configure our trends. In previous versions, the time range shown on the bottom of the display would always be the time range of the symbols on the display. In PiVision 2020, we can customize the time ranges for different trends. Let's see how it works. There are three ways that we can customize our time range. We can use the display time range. It keeps the same behavior as the rest of the display, and this is true for previous versions of PiVision. We can use a duration and offset. Here you can specify a different time range than the display, but it is still tied to the display's time range, as it's a relationship. You can change the duration, the length of time, or offset from either the start or end time, or do both an offset and change the duration. After I've made my changes for duration and offset, and I change the display's time range, we can see that the offset time range is updating, but it'll keep its settings. This can be helpful when doing root cause analysis, or when you expect different equipment to be running at different cycle times and want to compare them side by side on your display. This option also makes it easy to compare shifts. The third option is a custom time range. Here I can specify a hard-coded start and end time, which will divorce it from the display time range, and it will not update with any time changes to the display's time range. It gives you many options, like looking at quarterly, monthly, and daily trends all on the same display. To get the most out of these options, you can use PiTime abbreviations in these new time range options. So make sure to check out our other videos on PiTime if you want to learn more about additional options and setting your multiple time contexts on your trends. We hope you enjoy the new flexibility, and let us know if you have an interesting use case for the new time contexts in the comments.